All right, welcome to Frank Teaches DevOps, my lovely viewers. Thank you. Before I go ahead, I must appreciate each and every one of my fans that has given us that that ginger, you know, that push, you know, to be bringing out content, you know, content that changes lives. All right. So in today's series, today's episode, I will be talking about, we will be discussing about AWS application migration service. All right. So AWS application migration service. So what do we mean by AWS application migration service? So this is a service on AWS that enables you to migrate your on-premise workload, all right? So let me put this definition properly, all right? So this service enables you to what? To migrate your on-premise workloads to AWS. All right, so when we say your on-premise workload, it means that if you have servers, all right, servers running on-premise. Now, let's say you have servers running in your on-premise environment, all right? Servers such as if you have virtual machines, if you have VMs, let's put it like this. If you have VMs, right? If you have physical servers, right? Physical servers as well, which you want, there are applications, right? There are workloads running on those physical servers, and you want to migrate the entire physical server to AWS, right? And you also have VMware, all right? There are virtual machines. Virtual machines comes. If you also have Hyper-Vs, or virtual machines, all right. So VMware's, we're talking about Hyper-V, okay. We're not talking about KVM. We're not talking about VMware from vSphere, vCenter, all right. If you have these virtual machines, all right, running in on this platform, Hyper-V, KVM, VMware, you can actually migrate these machines, these virtual machines from your on-premise environment into the cloud. Likewise, if you have physical servers in your data center, all right, you can actually migrate them to your what? To your AWS. Also, you can migrate virtual machines on Azure VMs. Azure VMs or VMs on GCP. GCP VMs, etc. So you can migrate any virtual machine, any workload from anywhere to what? To AWS. That is what this video is all about. And the idea, all right, the mechanism you're going to be using is called lift and shift. Lift and what? Shift. Now, let me take it. You've seen the definition. Let's look at architecture. So this is my architecture. And I have my on-premise architecture. Right, so in my on-premise architecture, I have my app server, I have my DB server, I can have a number of servers, all right, depending on my workload. All right, so now what we're going to be doing in today's video, we would be what, migrating these workloads, app server and DB server, to what? To AWS. So at the end of the day, we're going to implement what we call lift and shift. Let me copy these DBs. Let me start with the app server. So I copy, all right. So I'm going to lift this guy. I've lifted this guy. I'm going to shift it towards AWS. So this is what's going to happen. My app server is now on AWS. I'll do similar thing, copy and paste, do similar thing to my DB server. All right. So I'm going to lift it and what? I'm going to shift it towards AWS. So as at the end of the day, I'll now have this workload, this on-premise workload, onwards on AWS, right? Nothing will change. All I have on my on-premise will be what? Will be shifted, will be lifted and shifted to what? AWS. So that is the architecture. Then let's now look at the demo. I don't know, we don't have much to explain, right? Because this is a lift and shift, right? You've seen what the definition here. This service enables you to migrate your on-premise workload to what? AWS. Not too much definition, all right? Now, what can we lift? You can lift virtual machines, you can lift physical machines, you can lift virtual machines that runs on other cloud providers, all right, to AWS. So simple and straight. It's understood, right? Great. Now let's now move forward toward how do we set up this environment to perform this lifting and shifting. So this is what I will be doing because I don't have what's it called? I do not have physical machine, neither do I have a virtual machine on other cloud providers. So I will be using my AWS virtual machines as my on-premise virtual machines. I don't really understand. Yeah, I'll be migrating my virtual machine, my workloads from AWS to AWS. It's assuming that my virtual machines are on-premise. That's the idea, all right? That's the idea, all right? But whatever I do works with whatever you have, wherever you have them, all right? So now, assuming we have the following servers, app and DB servers on-premise, all right? Now, app server has our application running on it, and DB server has MySQL or any database engine running on it, all right? Great. So I'm going to go to my AWS, which is on my on-premise, and create these two servers, okay? So I'll create these two servers, all right? So I'll go to AWS, go to EC2, okay? Launch instance. So let me call this app server. All right, so I need how many of it? I need two of these based on Amazon Linux. Right, keep it simple, T2 micro, key pair, that's a key, network settings, Frank VPC, okay, security group, Frank SG. So this is a normal process to create an EC2, all right? Launch. So now I'm going to have two of these guys. This will be app server. Let me edit this guy. And this will be what? DB server. All right. So, all right. So now, okay. So what will happen is I'm going to start with the app server. I'm going to create a simple HTML, CSS application on the app server. And I'm going to install MySQL on the DB server. So once I'm done with that aspect, then I'll now go ahead to migrate my virtual machines from on-premise to the cloud. So let's see now. Let's go back to this. This is the app server that started running. So let me open the app server, SSH clients, copy, come over here. All right, sudo dash I, great. So now this is my app server. So I want to install HTTP web server, Apache. So I'll say yum install HTTPD, okay? So I want to set up a simple web application. It's not really a web application, but just an HTML base. So I will restart my what? HTTP, the Apache server that's been restarted. Then I'll keep it on, enabled, I'll enable the service. The service has been enabled. So let's check the status of Apache is up and running. Okay, great. So now go to GitHub. Sorry, I'll go to Google and look for simple HTML one page. Simple HTML CSS projects. GitHub, and I'm not this
I need something. Project GitHub. Okay. HTML, CSS. I need something simple. Simple, simple, simple. Shadow e-commerce. Let me take this. Let me take this, guys. All right. So this, I'm going to git clone this guy. I'll clone it. Come to my server. All right. So I'm going to install Git. Yum install Git. I'll install Git on it. All right. Great. Now I'll go to var www.html. All right. In here, I'll now say Git I need. Initialize the directory. Then I'll say git clone. Git clone and paste that URL. Perfect. Now we have your e-commerce. So I'll copy everything recursively. All right. I'll copy everything under here into this directory. It has been copied. All right. Now I'll remove this e-commerce folder. Perfect. Now our website is set. So now I'll go to my URL. Let me close all of these guys. I'm through. Now open your duplicates this area. Now go to your EC2 instance and pick for your apps. This is your app server, right? Now pick the public IP. Go to your browser and hit enter. We should have our website, right? So this is our web application running on our app server. So this is our app server. So this app server is running a web application. And this is the web application. It's running an e-commerce based web application. That is fine. Now let's do the same thing for what our DB server. So I'll connect to the DB server, connect. So this DB server, I will be installing what we call a MySQL, all right? I will be installing MySQL. So let me paste that. All right, sudo and we are in. So I just install MySQL. So yum install MySQL server. MySQL. Let's see what we'll get. MySQL. So what I'm getting, so it's bringing me MariaDB. Well, that's fine. Okay, that's okay. All right, so I should have MySQL now. Do I have it? Great. So I have MySQL. So MySQL dash u, MySQL dash u, user is root, then p. All right. So I've not set password. So let's configure MySQL for the first time. So I would say, where is that command? MySQL check, MySQL find, initial config. All right. So let me install this client, MySQL, yum install MariaDB. Let's install everything about MariaDB. All right, great. So this should bring us with initial configuration of MySQL. All right. So we can log on to our DB database and create some database and tables. All right, great. Now, so let's see what we have now. All right, great. So MySQL initial config, MySQL setup, where is that? Secure installation, all right. So this is what we have. So MySQL secure install. All right, so now enter current password for root. Current password for root, I'll call it 1234. One, two, three, four, five, six. No. Okay, let me exit. Sorry, guys. MySQL. One sec, guys. MySQL dash P. One sec. All right, guys. So let's now start off with logging into our MySQL instance. Okay, MySQL underscore secure. Okay, secure. Let's see. So root password, I want to leave root password and empty. Hit enter. So set root password. I can say, okay, let me say yes. Root password, I want to give it 1212. Remove anonymous user, yes. Disallow root login remotely, yes. Remove test database, yes. Reload privilege, yes. That's all. Thank you for using MariaDB. So I can log in now. MySQL dash user root password is 1212. Why is it? Dash P 1 2. Okay, now. All right, so now I'm now in my database. Show databases. So these are the databases I have. So let me just create a database. So create database. Let me call it migration service DB. Migration service DB. Okay, it's completing of that that symbol. So migration MGS DB, right? So show databases. Okay, so I've created what? MGS DB, right? So let me create one more. Create database demo DB, right? So show databases, show databases. So I have two DB now, demo DB and MGS DB. So guys, we've created our app application, on our app server, and we've also created what? A database, MySQL, on our DB server. So I want to migrate these two machines that is on our on-premise environment into what? AWS. And to achieve that, we would be using what? This documentation from what? AWS. So take note, guys. This is the documentation I will be heavily relying on. And I've opened that page. It's somewhere here. Let me close my documentation. So this is the documentation. So let's go through documentation side by side. All right, so this is it. Now migrate your on-premise workload walkthrough. Okay, so here what they've used the Ubuntu, okay, app server running on Ubuntu and the backend supported by MySQL server running on Ubuntu as well, but I'm using Amazon Linux. Okay, now the key steps of this migration process are, first you have to create an IAM user for AWS replication agents. Second, you create the replication settings template in the AWS migration console. Install the AWS migration agents on the source servers, all right? Configure the launch settings in this console, launch test settings, launch cutover, finalize cutover. So let's go through the prerequisites, okay? What is needed, all right? For this walkthrough, complete the following prerequisites. First, we already have an AWS account that's gone. Have a clear understanding of VPC, okay? Then create the virtual networking environment for the purpose of this walkthrough as shown in this figure. So this figure, right? This is the figure. So now we're going to walk through the entire this process. First, they said we should create a VPC, call it MGN Demo VPC. So let's create this VPC. So I'll go to my AWS account, duplicate this. So I'll go to VPC. So on VPC, click on create. Okay, so I want to create everything at once. So this is what I will do. So I'll use this VPC and more feature. I'll come here. I'll say MGN demo VPC. All right, great. So check the documentation. Now create three subnets in the demo VPC. All right, MGN demo VPC, staging area subnets, migrating resources public subnet, and migrated resource private subnets. So these are the three subnets, 1, 2, and 3. Okay, now create internet. Okay, let's create those subnets now. Let me copy everything. I'll copy, come over here. So they said, let's read the game because there's something they said. Okay, public subnets, and this staging area subnet is also a public subnet. All right, let's go back there. So this is public subnets without name tag. Let me come here. Let me paste this guy. So we are creating public subnet, right? Staging area. It has to be staging area. Cut. Staging area subnet, right? So let me put a dash in between. Staging area subnets. Then I need another public subnet, which is this one. Cut this guy. This is migrated resources public subnets. The dash in between. Then we now have, let me do something. I'm in the availability zones. Let me make it 3 availability zones, right? So now I have the last one, which is a private subnet. So the private subnets, I could make it, okay, let me make it 3. Private subnets, all right? Can put it in A, or can put it in C. So here comes the private subnets. Okay, let's come the private subnets. Great. So I have 3 subnets: staging area subnets, migrated resources public subnets, and migrated resource private subnets. Now let's say that, let's look at the documentation. It says we should create an internet gateway. All right. Now create 2 routables: public MGN demo routable and private MGN demo route table. Let's come there, come over here, routable. These are routable, right? Public. One will be public, which is this. And the other will be private. This is private. Okay, great. Private, public and private. Now let's go back. Now add internet routes to the public MGN demo routable with internet gateway as target, then associate the staging area subnet and migrated resources public subnet with the public MGN demo routable. So that has already been associated. So what we need to do, we need to create an internet gateway. All right. So let's come over here. So let me call this guy MGN IGW. All right. MGN internet gateway. You can see this guy is already routed to the public. You can see if I hover, you can see some blue signals, all right, to differentiate from other options, all right, from other options as well. So you have public MGN routable. It's already associated with what, my internet gateway. So my staging area subnet, being a public subnet, has already been associated with my what, public MGN routable. Likewise, my migrated resources public subnet has also been what, being associated with my what, public MGN route table. Okay, great, great. I think that's it. That's all. So now let's look at our documentation. We've done the entire association. And associate the migrated resource private subnet with the private MGN route table. Now let's look at the private MGN route table. Where's the private MGN? This is a private MGN route table, which is already associated with this guy, all right? Private MGM. All right, why is it? Okay, let me copy it from here. This is the route table. Got it. Great. All right. So they're now associated accordingly. All right. So take note, guys. All right. They're associated accordingly. Okay. Great. I think that's all. That's all. Okay. That's all. So let's launch the VPC. Come to over here. Let's launch the VPC. All right. Number of public subnets. Public subnets 3. Number of private subnet 3. That's okay. That's okay. That's fine. Click on what? Create. Create VPC. So this is now creating what? Our VPC. Created. Let's view the VPC. So under VPC, we have the NGN VPC. Go to subnets. We have the migrated resource subnets and staging area subnets. Likewise, the words migrated resource private subnet. And routables. So you can see we have two routables, public MGN and private MGN. And internet gateway, we already have what, the MGN IGW. So if you go to subnets and I check this first guy, check my routable, you can see that we already have a route to the internet. All right. Great. Great. So let's go back to our documentation. The documentation says launch an EC2 instance as a bastion host in the migrated resources public subnets. Okay. Create two security group, public MGN demo and private MGN demo. Now, add inbound rules for HTTP and HTTPS ports from anywhere and SSH ports from the bastion host public IP address to the public MGN. All right, so let's do this first. Let's create these two security groups. All right. So copy these guys. Copy. What's this? So copy these guys. Copy. So let's go to EC2 and go to security group. Security group, security group. And let's create those two security groups. So create security group, right? So the first security group, there we go. Right? This is what? Public MGN. Allow some access. Now, in which VPC? In the MGN demo VPC. Take note, guys. The inbound rule, add the rule. The first rule they said we should add is what? HTTP. There's a HTTP for everywhere, all right? The second rule they said we should add is HTTPS, HTTPS anywhere. So let's check. The other rule is what? SSH. SSH anywhere. So let's check our documentation. So now add inbound rules for HTTP, HTTPS from anywhere and SSH port from the bastion host. Remember, we've not created this bastion host, public IP address to the public MGN demo. All right, they said we should launch a bastion host. Okay, great. All right, we need the security group to create this bastion host. All right, so let's create the security group first before we. Now, the last one now says add inbound rules for MySQL port from this guy to this guy. And SSH port from the bastion host private IP address. So this is what we'll do. Okay. So let me save this guy. I've created this security group. Let's create. Okay. This has been created. All right. Now let's create another security group. Create security group, which is what? The private. All right. Allow some access. Now the VPC we bought, MGN demo VPC. For now, I'm not going to add any rule. Let's leave the rule out now. Let's create Let's just create that private VPC, all right? That's been created. Now let's go back to this other part that says what? Launch an EC2 instance as a bastion host in the migrated resources public subnet. So this is what we'll do. So we'll go to EC2 instances, all right? And launch an instance. Let's call that instance MGN bastion. MGN dash bastion, okay? It's going to be based on Amazon Linux. There will be this and T2 micro. Then key pair should give it this key. Network settings. Remember, it has to be in MGN demo VPC. Now, the subnet has to be, they say, migrated resources public subnet. Migrated resources public subnet. I didn't enable auto assign public IP. All right. So let me do that quickly. So in my migrated resource public subnet, I need to enable subnet settings and I need to enable auto assign public IP and DNS name as the case may be. I will do the same thing for staging as well. Here is staging. Action. Okay. Action, subnet settings, enable and enable, save. All right, so that's okay. So come back to creating your bastion host. So let's just put this enable at once. And existing security group. This guy has to be, let's look at the documentation. Instance as bastion host in the migrated resources public subnet, all right? So it has to be in, it has to be in the words, the migrated, the public MGN demo security group. Okay, great. Then the size is, let me just give it 10 GB. I think that's all. Now click on what? Launch instance. So you can see we've actualized this part, which was creating the bastion host. Okay. Now come down to this last part. Add inbound rules for my SQL ports from this public subnet to the private demo SG and SSH port from the bastion host private IP. So what this thing means is I'm going to go back to the security group. Where is that security group? The private MGN security group. So here's the private MGN security group. Let me give it a name. That's the name. Then where's my public? This is the public. So for the private MGN, I need to add inbound rules. Go to inbound rules, edit inbound rules. So they say add a rule. Now let's look at it. What they say. They say add the MySQL port, all right? Coming from what? This public MGN. So let's go there. So this, it has to be custom TCP. So my SQL runs on 3306, all right? So the source has to be custom. Then is it coming from where? It's coming from the public security group, all right? So that's what this guy means. So it is only all the resources that have the public subnets as their subnet that can access this port on the private security group, right? So that was this guy, this rule means, okay? That's what it means. This we've achieved to the security group, to the private, this guy, and SSH ports from the bastion host private IP. So we'll go back there. So I'll also add another rule for SSH. SSH, this time around, is going to be the private IP address of my bastion host. So as you can see, let's go back to instances. I have my bastion. This is my bastion host. Here's my bastion host. My bastion host has what? A private IP. So I'll copy this private IP. I need to give this guy access on what? On this private subnet, all right? So it will be custom, then it has to be this IP address. Can you see the IP address? So this is my bastion host IP address. My bastion host IP address is going to have SSH access to any resource that has been deployed within this private security group. So that's it. Add the rules. roles have been added. Let's go back to our documentation. Now, all that have been achieved. So the next one says, AWS MGN requires network connectivity to and from your on-premises environment and within your Amazon VPS. That's fine. That's fine. Okay, that's all right. So great. Now, let's now start the real business. The real business now says, create an IAM user for AWS replication agent. All right, create an IAM user for AWS replication agent. So now, once you create that user, you assign this policy, this inbuilt policy to that user. It's called AWS Application Migration Agent Policy. So let's go there now. Let's go there now. So duplicate. Let's go to IAM. Let's IAM. Open. So I'm going to IAM. So, all right, users. I'm going to add a user. Let me call that user MGN. MGN user. All right. MGN user. User provide user access to the console. Auto-generated password. That's fine. User must create. No, I don't want. All right. So next. Now I need to add some policies. All right. I need to attach policies. Go to attach policies directly. So the kind of policy I need to attach is what's the name of that policy? Is application migration. So I'll search for application migration. Application migration agent policy. AWS application migration agent policy. So this is the policy that I need to attach. Scroll down and click on what's next and create. Create. So let's look at that policy again. Application migration agent policy. All right, so this has been created. I can download my user what credential, NGN user that's been downloaded. Okay, return to user list. Great. Now, the next step now says what? Create a replication settings template. Create a replication what settings template. Now, what do we do? Now, they say to migrate your servers from on-premises or another cloud service provider, create your replication settings to initialize the service for the first time in the AWS MGN console. You can access AWS console through AWS console. So now let's go towards AWS console now. So on my AWS console, let me duplicate this page, duplicate. I should look for application migration service. So is the service is application migration. So here's the service, AWS application migration service. So click on the service. So we've clicked on that service. So what do they say? So we have different aspects. We have source servers. Let me shrink these guys so you see everything, how it works. I think that's all. So close some of these guys. All right, waves, global, launch history, everything. I did some jobs later, a few days ago. Replication templates, launch, blah, 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 blah. All right, great. So let's go back. Now let's go to our documentation. So the documentation says that we should create a replication settings template. All right, great. So this is what we'll do. We're going to click on settings, go to settings and click on what? Replication template. All right. So here's my replication template. So I need to create a new one. So let's check what we have here. So the replication server has to be staging. So let's go there. Let's do something. Let me check. Okay, edit. All right. So you click on edit. So that's what you do. Click on what? Edit and staging area subnets. You assign your staging, the staging area subnet that you created. You can see now, staging area subnet has to be what? Staging area subnet that you created. All right, under replication servers. All right, so come over here. Your subnets will be staging area subnets. So that's the subnet that we created. Then the instance type of the replication server. So what they've used, what T3 small. So let's use T3 small. Come over here. I'll say what T3 small, which we already have there. Then for the volume, it's going to be a faster general purpose SSD, and the EVS inscription is default. Let's go there. So it has to be faster general purpose SSD. EVS encryption is default. Then security group. Let's see what they did under security. So always use application migration service security group. So check the box. So come over here. Always use application migration service. Leave this empty. Then data routing and throttling. Create public IP. Let's see what they have here. Create public IP. So that's all. Now let's click on create to create the guide now. I think that's all. Now click on what? Save template. So replication template saved. So this template has what? Has been saved, right? So here's a template that's been saved. And let's go back to the next option. Let's option now says what? Install the AWS replication agent. Now after AWS MGN has been initialized, all right? You can see it has already been what? Initialized. So if you ask, that's why you're saying reinitialize service permissions, all right? So that's then, you know, with the creation of the replication template settings, and you have generated the required AWS credentials. We are going to generate AWS credentials for that user, the MGN user, with the necessary permission. Now, install the AWS replication agent on the source servers on premises. There are separate installation instructions for Linux and Windows operating system, all right? For Linux and Windows operating system. So what I will do now is I'm going to create these credentials. So I'll go to IAM. So I'll go to the MGN user, all right? I'll go to security credentials. Then I'll come to what? Access keys, create access keys, command line interface. That's okay. Next. And let's just say, okay, create access key. So I've created what the access key and what the secret key of the MGN what user. So now what do they say now? Now we're going to log on to our servers on premise and launch these agents, all right? So the first agent is this guy. So now we've already launched these guys. So yeah, let me quit. All right, so here I have my what DB server. So this is the DB server. Let me set a host name. Host name DB server. So I exit and come back. So that's my DB server. So if I exit again, host name DB server. So I have to be root. So sudo that. So bash. Perfect. Now we now have what? A DB server. All right. All right. So this is a DB server, and this will have to be the host name app server. Okay. So sudo app server, sudo hostname, sudo hostname app server. So bash that. All right, great. So we have the app server, then we now have what? The DB server. So now on our app server, we will be installing what? The agent. All right. So now let's copy this agent, copy it as it is. Copy, come over to the app server, and let's launch it. Enter. So great. So this has been installed, right? So now the next step is to install the replication agent. Before we do that, okay, let's go ahead. So copy this guy, copy it, copy, come over here and paste it, enter. So this guy will request for the AWS region that we are working with. So it's EU West 1. EU West 1. Okay. EU West 1. then AWS one is going to request for what? The access key. All right. So the access key now will be, let's go to IAM. So copy this access key, come over here and let's paste the access key. Paste it. Is it pasted? That's it. Enter. So it will now request for the what? Access key. So come over here. Sorry, secret key, sorry. So copy the secret key and over, right click and paste. That's it. And enter. So now choose the disk you want to replicate. All right. So I have this disk XVDA. So to replicate some of the disks, type the path of the disk separated with what? Comma. To replicate all of your disks, just press enter. So I want to replicate all of my disks. So I'll press what? Enter. So I'll press enter. So it's now saying what? Identify volume replication disk of size 10 GB. All volumes for replication was successfully identified. It takes some time, all right? So while I'm waiting for this guy, let's do the same thing on the DB server. So I'm going to do similar thing on the DB server. So go to your documentation, copy this Python script, download this Python script, all right? Come over to your DB server and let's paste it. Paste it over there and hit enter. Okay, great. Now do the second thing for the second part. Copy it and let's go and paste. So let's paste it. It asks for the region EU West 1. So that is it. So it's going to ask for the access key ID. So here's my access key ID. So let's go, right click and paste, enter. It's going to ask for the secret key ID. So copy and let's go in there, right click and paste. So there we go. All right. All the digs. Perfect. So let's wait and take some time, guys. This thing takes some time. So I'll pause the video. Once it's finished, I'll be right back. All right. So as you can see, the replication has been done successfully. All right. So installing the replication agent onto the server is finished. Syncing source server with replication migration console finished, and replication agent was successfully what installed. So this is the app server. Let's check the DB server. So DB server is still ongoing. So DB server is still ongoing. So now if I go to my console now, right? If I go to my console, I go to source servers. I should see one server already. You can see this app server. You can see. So this is the app server. App server is already here. Okay. Now let's wait for the DB server. This thing is fun, guys. It's fun. Let's wait for the DB server to replicate itself. Okay. So let me remove this, guys, so you can see. So the migration lifecycle is not ready, and the data replication status is still what? Initiating. All right. So this process takes almost like 30 minutes. It takes a long time. All right. So it takes a long time. Let's wait for the DB server to be migrated to the, thank you, DB server is up here now. You can see now, DB server is up. So it says it's finished. So we now have what? The DB server on AWS, all right? Now I have it on AWS. So this process takes a lot of time. Now let's check our documentation. So now the installer prompts you to enter AWS region, AWS access key, secret key. So this we've done, let's go. Repeat the same replication agent installation process on all source servers, which you've done, all right? So this is good. So this is what you will see. You see what? Not ready, all right? So let's wait. Now, after the initial sync is complete, which is the data replication status, all right? Once it is complete, the migration lifecycle, which is this column, the migration lifecycle will display ready for testing. And the data replication status displays as healthy. All right. Now, this part, let me do it from here. Now, this part is going to display, what's going to display? It's going to display ready for testing. All right. This part is going to display ready for testing. Then this part is going to display what? Healthy. Right. It's going to display healthy. This process takes, like I said, 30 minutes, almost 30 minutes. So I'm going to be pausing the recording and Once we are there, I'll be right back. Pause recording. Let me show us where we are now. So this is the initial sync, and we are almost like 13% gone, which is the app server is 13% gone, and the DB server is 9% gone, all right? So I'll be pausing the recording, all right? We still have 12 minutes to go and 15 minutes to go, respectively. So I'll pause in the video, and once it finishes, we'll be right back. So you can see it's still ongoing, and we are at 64% and 54% respectively, right? So I'll still pause it, and once this is done, we will be right back. So as you can see, the process is now at, initial sync is now at 100%. However, it's still creating what? It's not creating the snapshots, right? So let's still wait for a few time, right? It takes a lot of time. So I will be pausing the video, and once it's done, I'll be right back. All right, so now as you can see, we now have the migration lifecycle state to be ready for testing, right? So now our app server and DB server, they're now ready for testing, and the replication status is now is healthy. According to what we have here in this documentation, it says that these columns has to be in the ready state, ready for testing, and healthy. And the replication, data replication status has to be ready, healthy, respectively. So that we have achieved in this state. Let's move forward. Now, I said, we should configure the launch settings. All right. Now, prior to testing or cutting over an instance, configure the launch settings. All right. The launch settings are a set of instructions that determine how a test or cut over instance is launched for each source server in AWS, right? So now the launch setting is just like a launch template if you're conversant with EC2 instance launch templates, all right? So now we are going to select the server, select each server, and select the tab for launch settings to edit the launch settings. So let's start with the app server. So this is the app server. So I'll select the app server, all right? Then I'll go towards the launch settings menu. All right, so I'll go to the launch settings menu. So I'll click on the launch settings menu. I'll scroll down, I'll click on modify. Look at what we have here. What we have here is C5. So I'm going to change this to something else. So let's modify. Okay, and click on modify to open a new window. All right. So here's the launch settings. So let's see what we have here. On the documentation. Documentation says, all right. So for this walkthrough, we will keep the default settings for the general launch settings, and we will be making changes to the Amazon EC2 launch settings to replace app server and DB server in the right subnets, all right? So great. So now let's give it a name. Let's go to, let's call it, migrated, the name of the template, migrated app server. All right, migrated app server. Then let's scroll. We could leave the OS for now. Let's check app server. AMI, you leave the AMI blank. The instance type, let's put the instance type at C4 extra large, depending on what your requirements are. All right. So the instance type is CS4, C4 extra large. So here it is. So C4 extra large. Okay. That's the instance type. So they didn't include key pair, but me, I would love to include key pair. All right. So let's include key pair because I would love to access this machine as well. So my key pair is Frank Key. Then for the network settings, let's look at the network settings. What did they do? Right, the subnet is the public MGN, okay, all right, which is a security group. Let's check that. Let's check that. So they didn't put anything in the subnets. Let's check. MGN resources and migrated resources public subnets. Okay, so if I should take that, okay, migrated resources subnets, subnet info. So network interface. All right, okay. So let's go over here. It's just normal subnets which I created. Then security group. We have to use an existing security group, which is the public MGN demo SG. As you can see here, that's what they have used here as well. All right. So then for storage, did they do anything on that storage? No. You say what? Create template version. So they didn't do anything on that storage. So the storage is giving us 10 GB. You can always remove the storage and add more storage if you want more. All right. And these are resource tags. These are resource tags. And that's all. That's all. You can see the update is coming here. The instance type is this. There's no AMI. There's no AMI for now. And the security group is this. And the storage is 10 GB. I think that's all. And the name of the launch template is migrated app server. So click on what create template version. So this template version has been created. So if we view the launch templates, so created and used by application migrated service, created and used by application migrated service. Which one did we just create now? Let's see. I'm not seeing that. What time is it now? Let me check. Now it's 12:28. 12:28. Let me check this. The time. 11:02. Let me check this again. 11:04. Okay. All right. So all right. So let's go back here. It has been created. The launch template has been created. All right. So view launch template, which we did. Now in the launch templates window that shows up, select the launch template ID and select actions in the top right corner. And then select the set default version. So let's go there now. Let's check if which one, because we choose the instance type to be C4X. So this is not this. Let's check this other one. Let's check. What am I not getting? There are different versions. Let me check. Let me check. Let me check, guys. Let me open this. C4 extra large. Let me check this version. Version 3. All right. So version 3 of this guy has that CX4 extra large. All right. Key pair is this. So come here. All right. And go to actions. And set this version as the default version. So currently what we have as the default version is version 2. And version 2, you can see, default version, version 2. And version 2 does not have our changes. You can see, CS5. So this is version 3 that has the changes that we need. C4 extra large, all right? So we'll come to actions and click on what? Set default version, all right? So the default version is migrated app server. So select this guy that has been selected, migrated app server, all right, and click on what set as default what version. So this default, the default version of what has been set as what version 3. So let's go back there and so set the default version, All right, that's been set. Return to the, now the next step, we should return to the AWS MGN console and select the source server for the app server. Under launch settings, find the updated EC2 instance launch settings. So we should come back to our AWS console, all right, and select the app server, which is selected, and let's refresh. Without even refreshing, you can see now that's updated towards C4 extra large. That's updated towards C4 extra large. So migrated servers are now using what the launch templates, right? We also have, where's the key pair? That key pair is not shown, but this is it. So this is it, all right? The volume is 10 GB, all right, great. So let's also look at the other server, which is a DB server. Let's see if it must have been updated as well. Go to launch settings. Let's see. So this guy is still using what? C5. So I'll do the same thing, right, for these DB server as well. Let's refresh. It's refreshing, so it's not picking up. Okay. Now launch settings. Let's go to what? Modify. All right. Modify. And with that modify, let me see if I can use it directly from here. I can't edit. This is post launch settings, nothing. Launch settings. All right, launch settings and modify. Okay, so this will be migration DB server, right? That's a template name. Okay, we'll do similar thing. Leave OS empty. So the instance type would be C4 extra large. C4 dot extra large. C4 extra large. The key pair is Frank key. All right. The network will have to be public subnet. Security group. Which for DB server, right? This is DB server. DB server must have the what's it called? The private. Let's check the documentation. All right. So this was this. Okay. Now say what? Launch template modification for the what DB server which you are doing. So the templates, the subnets, the security group has to be what private this. Then and leave auto assign public IP disabled. Should we, so the subnet will have to be the private subnet. Great. So come over here. Sorry, not here. Come over here. So the subnet has to be private because it's a DB server. We don't want to expose it to the internet. All right. Migrated resource private subnet. All right. Security group will have to be security group will have to be the private MGN. That's it, guys. Then, okay, let's make this guy 20 GB or 15 GB. So I'll remove this volume and add new volume. So volume type will be, let's say 15 GB to see the difference. Okay. And can pick from anywhere. Device name, let's say this, and is input output performance something IOPS is 1500. Volume type is general purpose SSD GP3. All right. Deletion and termination. Done sets. I think that's all. That's all. That's all. 15 GB. Then resource tag. That's it. Go back. The template name is what? Migration DB server. Let's create templates. So create this template has been created. Let's view the template. So what do we have here? It's still on this. Let's check DB server. Let's check this. So let's check the version. This. Okay, this is default version. Let's see where would that version go to. All right, so we can set default version. All right, set default version. Select the version. The version is what? So this is updated. They said updated by application migration service. It's not here. Let me check the other ID. First, let me check the second ID. Let me check the second ID. Let's come here. Set default version. So this is what we have here. Migration DB server. All right. So this is migration DB server. So select it and click on what? Set as what? Default version. So that version has been set. So if we go back to our application migration service, this should be updated. You can see now that's already been updated. Then the volume is 15 GB. You can see everything has been what updated. All right. So now let's go to back to our servers. All right. So these guys have been updated, both the app server and the DB server. So let's continue with so we've done this, all right. Now the next step is they say you return to the AWS management console, select the source server for the DB server. Under launch settings, find the updated what EC2 launch settings. Now the next step is what? Launch the test instances. Now that you configure the launch settings for each source server, you are ready to launch the servers as test instances, right? Best practice is to test the instances before a cutover. They said what this thing means that we should test the instances before what we do a cutover. Now on the NGN console page, make sure that your source servers are ready for testing. So what we have here, our source servers, they are what? They are ready for testing. Now let's go back. Ready for testing by looking at the following indicators as shown in figure 14. The source servers are healthy and ready for what? Testing. Great. Now check the boxes to the left of each server. That's this check boxes. They say if you check it, that you want to launch a test instance. Select test and cutover. So you select this test and cutover in the top right-hand corner, then select what? Launch test instances. All right. So now let's do that immediately. Let's do that. Let's go to our MGN console. Select these two guys. Select these two guys. All right. Then go to what? Test and cut over and click on what? Launch test instance. So once you click on launch test instance, we're going to see that you are about to launch EC2 instances for two servers. All right. These instances will be launched according to the launch settings you have confirmed. So click on what? Launch now. Click on launch. So it now shows that test is in progress. All right. So this test is in progress. It takes a lot of time as well. So let's come back here. So launch. Now, this takes you back to the MGN console page with the source servers. Make sure that the migration lifecycle indicates that test is in what progress. Then select view job details. All right. Now let's go back there now. They said we should want select view job details. Make sure that the migration lifecycle column is what is in what test in progress, which we already have. So the answer is what view job details. So let's click on this view job details to see what's happening. So click on view job details. So now this is now work. The test, the launch test instance is now is ongoing, right? It's ongoing. So from time to time, we'll be seeing getting updates from what the job log, getting update from the job log. Now the status is already what started. So this status will change from started to what to completed. Then our launch test instance has been completed. Now let's look at the documentation. What did this say? Now check the job status as it changes from started to completed. You can also view the job logs from for more details. So it will change from what from started to what to completed. So let's look at that part that it will change from what started to completed. So we'll be monitoring this guy. You can see this populating the logs. All right. We are going to be monitoring this status. All right. So for the time being, I'm going to pause the video. Once it finishes, I'll be right back. So once the status changes to what changes to completed, we'll be right back. So let's pause it for now. Pause recording. Okay, guys, the process is still ongoing. All right, so you can see it's in progress. Okay, but we are getting some conversion. Conversion failed for app server. So let me see, because at this time, at this juncture, you may have gotten your what's it called? The EC2 instances on AWS. So you can see we have the app server, right, and the DB server. Okay. So the app server and the DB server. So this was the original one. What was the size? Because this was the original one. So this is the new one, all right. So after everything, right, it's going to create a new EC2 instance on EC2 on AWS, all right. Okay, so let's see why the launch template we did. Why is it complaining of failed? But let's see what happens. So started launch testing, cut over app server, this conversion ended. App server conversion ended for DB server, conversion failed. Okay, error, failed to connect to using HTTP channel. Well, let me check the security groups. Let me check those security groups. Why am I having that failure? Security group. This is this guy and inbound rules HTTP now. All right, so let's still observe and see what happens. All right, so that was page two. This page one in progress, page two. All right, so I'll be pausing the video, and once it's done, I'll be right back. All right, so as you can see, we now have the status as what completed. It took a lot of time, guys. So this successfully launched EC2 instance app server, successfully launched test DB server. Let's check page three, all right? Page three says job ended. So this job has ended, all right? So great. So now let's now go back to the source server. So once we go back to the source servers, we should see that we have a new column called alerts. So on this alerts column, we should have this indication that these servers we are successfully what launched. So if I go to my EC2 instance now, if I go to my EC2 instance, let me refresh. We should see that I have the DB server and the app server successfully what launched, right? I don't know why it's still picking up C5. So this is C4, right? So now we're standing. So this is it, all right? So let's continue. We are still going further. Now, they said now, once completed, return to the NGN console source server page. Now, the alerts show up as what launched. You can see now, the alerts shows up as what launched. So this is what we have here. The alerts shows up as what launched, all right? So let's continue. Now, making configuration updates to the WordPress app server. All right, so this is what they have on their WordPress or on the app server, right? So on the app server for this instance, they have what they have. They have a WordPress application, right? So they made the changes to their WordPress application, okay? And normally now, all right, normally. So what you go to your EC2 instance, you try to access your application. So now this is what I have now. This is my app server, right? So this was the old server. Take note, guys. So this was the old server. This was the old server, on-premise server, right? These are on-premise server. Now, this is now the cloud, the migrated server, which is app server, right? This is migrated app server. So this is what we have. Didn't give me public IP. Why? Which subnet did I? Which I enabled now? Didn't I enable public IP? All right, let's finish, guys. Let's finish. All right. So, okay, now updating the grant privilege on blah 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 blah. All right. The launch, we're supposed to launch this application now. So let me see something. Instance, this guy, app server. Why am I not getting public IP? Which template is this? It's picking up a wrong template. Picked up the wrong templates. Why? Connect. No, 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 no. Shouldn't have picked up the wrong templates. Let's see the documentation. Okay, let's finish. Let's see what happens. All right. So now we successfully launched application in the web browser. We're supposed to launch this application first in the web browser, guys. Why is it picking a wrong app server? Launch settings. No, 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 no. What happened now? Guys, I think we have to modify this thing because there's no public IP. There's no public IP. It won't work. All right. So let me modify this stuff. Let me modify, please. Let's modify this work. Let me call this now app-migrate. Why? So the default will be four, saying four. App-migrate. Manually select instance. Instance type, let me take C4, four times large. All right, it's a big money, guys. Let me take something small. T3 medium. Let me take T3 medium. T3 medium, key pairs this. Network settings. Network settings. Okay, let me use my own cloud network. But that's fine now. This is a launch template. It's a launch template. All right. It's a launch template. So let me use sub one. No. Wait 1 second, guys. I'm coming, guys. 1 second. Launch templates, migrated resource public. Security group is that. Okay. Oh, enable. We didn't enable public IP, guys. We didn't enable public IP. Frank SG. No, not Frank SG, please. Not Frank security group. There's a public security group. Sorry, MGN. Where's that security group? That's a security group. All right. Show selected. That's a security group. Enable public IP. This I didn't do. Why? Why didn't I do it? Enable public IP. I think we are good. How about keep a okay. I think we are good now. T3 medium create templates. View the templates. All right. So open this. The template is set the default, which is set default. Default has to be 6. App migrates, set default. All right. T3 medium. So if I come back over here, you have T3 medium. We now have T3 medium. Public IP, yes. All right. So that's fine. Okay. So I'll do the same thing for DB server. So DB server is fine at the level of DB server because we don't need any, what's it called? DB server. We don't need any public access to DB server. Let me check networking. So the networking we have here is the private subnet. That's okay. So DB server is fine. So it's just the app server that we have the challenge. T3 medium. All right. So let's go to the service. Let's go to app server. Come to test and cut over. I have to mark it. I have to redo it again. All right. So I have to launch test instance again on this only app server. So I'll launch test instance on that app server. This action cannot be performed on the server because you can only launch test instances for servers whose lifecycle status is ready for test. Okay. So what I'll do now, I'll mark it as ready for test. I'll revert this particular server to what? Ready for testing. So I'll revert it ready for testing. So let's revert. So I've reverted this guy back to what? Ready for testing. So now I can now what? Launch testing. All right. So this guy will be launching now. So let's view the job. So this is the job. So it will change to what? Completed once everything is gone. Once everything is done. No wonder we got that failure, conversion failure, HTTP channel. All right. So now let's observe this now. So while we are doing for this guy, let's duplicate and then continue the other process for DB server. All right. Go back to your source servers. Now for the DB server, now let's continue. We'll come back to app server. Where were we? So this guy has shown us what launch, right? So great. So they make the necessary changes. All right. They've launched it. Everything is fine. Now, with a successfully launched application in the web browser, you can select mark as ready for cutover. You can select what mark as ready for cutover. So what we'll do now, we'll come back here for this DB server. All right. So select this DB server, click test and cut over. We now come here, what? Mark as ready for cut over. Click on mark as ready for cut over and click on what? Continue. So now the state now is now what? Ready for what? Cut over. Now let's continue with what we have. So ready for cut over, click the boxes next to the server host name, select test and cut over. Okay. Okay, when the Mac servers are ready for cutover, dialog box appears. Choose continue. The source servers show up as what? Ready for cutover in the MGM console. Now, next step, launch the cutover instances. After completing the testing of all the source servers, you are ready for cutover. Prior to launching cutover instances, ensure that the source servers are listed as ready for cutover under migration lifecycle and healthy under data replication. So we come here, we should have under a migration lifecycle, we should have what? Ready for cutover. Then the replication should be what? Healthy. All right. So this guy is now ready for cutover. All right. Now let's do a cutover now. To do a cutover, once confirmed, check all the source servers to the cutover and then select launch cutover instances from the test and cutover drop down menu. So she calls from this test and cutover drop down menu, she select what? Launch cut over instances, all right? Launch cut over, all right? So click on launch cut over instance and click on what? Launch. On the DB server, make sure it is on DB server. So, all right, so, and choose launch to start the cut over. On the MGN console, the source servers show up as what? Cut over in progress. So let's check. Let's check that. It should show us cut over. Ready for cut over. It should show us something. All right. So let's view the job. View job that started. DB server. Let's go back. It should show us something. Ready for cut over. She's supposed to show us cut over in progress. All right. Cut over in progress. MGN console. Let's go back to the MGN console. This test launch cut over instances. Starting to launch cut over instances for one server. All right. So view the job. So it's completed, right? Cut over has been what? Completed. So let's check. Let's check the cut over. Let's check source servers. So DB server. See showing ready. Let's refresh. Let's refresh. Let's refresh. Let's refresh. But this guy took this old. I don't know why. All right. Okay. Launch settings. Why did he do that? 15 GB. It's adding another 10 GB. This C5. Okay, let's see what happens. Go back to servers. Why is it taking some time? So it's ready for cut over. It's ready for cut over now. So let's go to tests. Let me go back. Source servers, DB, ready for cut over. Test and launch cut over instances. Launch cut over instances. Launch cut over instances. Launch. Cut over in progress. So now I have cut over in progress. So let's view the job. So view the job. All right. So it have started. Cut over have started. Let's check this other job. So this other job for the app server is completed. All right. It's completed. So let's go to sources. Ready for testing. Still not completed. Ready for testing. App server. I'm coming, guys. Bam, bam, bam. It is for app server now, all right? App server. So great. So the next will be a cut over, all right? So launch cut over instances for the app server. So let's try to access the app server now. Let's see if this must have worked. So let's refresh. Where's our app server? Okay. All right. So one sec, guys. Ready for testing. App server. Ready for testing. sources. Ready for testing. Okay, it's showing ready for testing. Let's check a doc. Test in progress. Ready for testing. Right. So once it is ready for testing, you can now launch test instances, all right? For the app server tests, launch test instances, all right? Launch. All right, so test in progress. That's for the app server, all right? So let's view the job. Job have started. So job for this guy is still ongoing. The cut over is still ongoing. So I'll be pausing the video and I'll be right back. Okay, we now have a DB cutover instance completed. All right, meanwhile, okay, we also have the app server launch instance completed. So let's come back to source servers. All right. So this guy has gone through, DB server has gone through the process of cut over, and app server has gone through the process of launch instance. That's gone through launch test instance, right? So we have to mark our app server as ready for cut over. But before then, let's check if those launch settings are there. I don't know why it keeps defaulting back to C5. Public IP is yes. All right, keeps defaulting to C5. So let's check our instances and see if we can have the app server already up and running. So the DB server is up and running. So app server is not there yet. Okay, app server is there. So it's still saying C5. So let's check it. Let's check, it has a public IP, all right? So let's copy this public IP, then let's go to our web browser and let's launch it. So you can see our migrated server has these are migrated server, and our application is running on the migrated server. We are good, we are fine. Now let's come to the documentation. This was the part that's okay. Where's the part? So that's this part. They try to access the migrated server, all right? So, which is fine. So launch the app server in a web browser using your public IP address of the test app server. So which you've done, all right? So now is to mark this guy, the app server, as what? Mark it as ready for what? Cutover. Once you've marked it ready for cutover, then we can now go ahead to what? Launch cutover instance. So come to the app server. I think this is my app server. Come back to sources. So this is my app server. All right. So I'll come to test and mark as ready for what's cut over. All right. So continue. So I'll view the job for that. Where is that job? Should it be this? Ready for cut over. Okay, this is this. So that is the job. All right. So it doesn't take time. The status will change, all right, to completed, meaning that it's ready for cut over. So this app server is in progress, all right? So it takes some time, all right? Takes some time. So let's now look at our DB server. So our DB server is complete, all right? So let's go to servers. So our DB server is complete, all right? Cut over in progress is complete. So now let's go to our documentation. So our documentation says cut over in progress. All right, it has to launch, completed. Now, CEO, follow the same steps for making configuration update to the WordPress app with the new DB server host and updating grant permissions in MySQL database. All right, in MySQL database. So let's see, come over here. DB launch instance, view in EC2 console. Let's view it in EC2 console. So this is the DB server. All right. So DB server is running C5 lashes. That's our DB server, migrated DB server. All right. However, we might not be able to access this DB server from the public, right? From the public. We have to go through the app server or even the bastion host to access this what DB server. But everything is fine. All right. So let's continue. That's okay. Once you are finished with the update to the app and DB servers, and connectivity is confirmed using a web browser to launch the application, and all other performance tests has been performed, you can now make changes to the DNS records to point to the new app server. All right. So let's finish this aspect, because great, this guy is now completed. All right. So for the app server, let's go to app server. You know, we did something, so it's now ready for cutover. All right, so can now what launch a cutover for the app server. So here's the app server. So app server is now ready for cutover. So click on this guy. Let me close some of this job. All right, click on the app server, test and this. All right, you can now click what launch cutover what instance. All right, launch cutover instance. So click on launch cutover instance, which is one server, and launch. All right, so cutover in progress. So let's view the job. So we're going to wait for the app server to be at the same level with the DB server. Then we can now finalize. So the DB server is already in the cutover in progress. All right, so we can now what complete the cutover. All right, so DB server is almost there. DB server is almost there. So let's wait for the app server. Then we can do it all together. So while we are waiting for the app server to get completed, we will pause the video and we'll be right back. All right, guys, now that we now have the app server cutover completed, so let's go to our source servers. So I now have the app server and the DB server at the same level, all right? They're now at the same level. So now the next step is to finalize the cutover, right? So let's look at our documentation. All right, great. Now this is the final part, which is what finalize cutover, all right? So finalize the cutover. So once you are finished with the update to the apps and DB servers, and connectivity is confirmed using a web browser to launch the application, and all the performance tests has been performed, you can now make changes to the DNS records to point to the new app server. All right, so you can make some changes. You want to set DNS record and all of that. All right, great. So now we need to finalize what the cutover. But before then, let's still check if our website is up. Okay, this has gone down. This has gone down. Maybe that's okay. Let's check the new instance. This was the DB server. Refresh. DB server is up. Let's check the new app server. So this is a new app server which is being initialized. So this is a new app server. Click on it. Go to copy the public IP. Come to your browser and boom. So this is our application. All right. Great, guys. So great. So everything is fine. We are now at the final stage to finalize the cutover. So let's look at the documentation. So now that you have successfully performed a cutover, you can finalize the cutover. This changes the source server's migration lifecycle status to cutover complete. Sorry. So if we finalize this cutover, it's going to change this migration lifecycle towards cutover complete. In addition, this terminates the replication server and all data replication is stopped and discarded. So it means that once we finalize this process, all right, the data here will be terminated, all right? All these data in my source server will be terminated. Then everything now will now be moved towards to your AWS EC2 instance dashboard, okay? So now in the NGN console, select the boxes next to the source servers, which is this, that you want to finalize cutover. Select finalize cutover from the pull-down menu under test and what cutover. So let's do that and finalize. All right, let's do that. So you will see what cutover complete. Let's do that. So come over here. Select the servers, all right? So go to what? Test and cut over. Test and cut over. All right. Test and cut over. All right. Test and cut over. And click on what? Finalize cut over. Finalize cut over. So we are going to be finalizing these two cut overs, these two servers. Click on what? Finalize. So you can now see that this guy, migration lifecycle has changed to what? Cut over complete. And data replication has been disconnected. And the next step is marked as was archived. So everything now has been archived. All right. Everything now has been what? Archived. Let's see. Yeah, everything has been archived automatically. So let's go and check the documentation. All right. So mark as archived. So for cleanup, mark the resource. Okay. For cleanup, mark the resource servers as archived. Archiving prevents the servers from being shown in the servers list page. All right. So we're going to mark these servers as archived. In the MGL console, check the boxes next to the resource servers that you want to mark as archive. Archiving servers prevent them from being shown in the servers list page. Select mark as archive from the drop-down menu for actions. All right. So let's go and do that. Come over here. All right. It has been marked as archive. So select them, come to actions, and click on what? Mark as archive. That's the next step. So the moment you mark as archive, it's going to terminate these instances. Everything will clear off. It has archived these two servers, so you can't see them anymore. So at this juncture, migration lift and shift has been completed. It's said to be completed. So now let's check again. So archive. Now the source servers are now archived and removed from the AWS management, AWS Migration Service Console page. Now cleaning up. To avoid incurring future charges, delete the resources that we have created during the walkthrough and remove credentials created. So far, so good. At this juncture, we have successfully migrated our workload. Let's go back to this guy. We've successfully migrated both app server and DB server from our on-premise environment to our AWS. So if we go to EC2 instance now, go to EC2 instance, we should have our DB server and our app server running as expected. All right. So now run as expected. So you can see we had this originally. We had the app server and the DB server originally on our on-premise. So these were the two servers that we migrated, right? So these are the two servers that we migrated from our on-premise to AWS. We migrated these two servers from here back to here. So these are them, right? So perfect. So at this juncture, we've been able to what? To perform a lift and shift, right? We've been able to what? To perform a lift and shift of our resources running on our on-premise infrastructure, all right? Our on-premise environment towards the AWS, which is the cloud environment. Thank you very much, guys. Thank you for your patience. Thank you for the walkthrough. It's been a tedious one, but it's been very, very educative. So thank you, and see you in our next episode. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Have a lovely afternoon.